This is Nightline, February 29th, 2012.
Good evening, I'm Terry Moran. Well, the Church of Scientology is one of the world's newest religions and growing, opening dozens of new churches around the world and making high-profile converts in places like Hollywood. But tonight, a former Scientology insider will allege that there is much we don't know about this famously powerful, wealthy, and secretive institution. Allegations of misuse of power and physical harassment. ABC's Dan Harris brings us an exclusive interview with a woman who was once a high-ranking church official. In his report, Scientology, an insider speaks.
Scientology, a church known for celebrity,
what are Scientologists?
Secrecy, and controversy.
No, I'm not stopping here. You listen to me for a second.
And now the latest PR hit involves a former high-ranking insider named Debbie Cook, who's being sued by the church and is fighting back by making headline-generating allegations in open court about what she says happened to her behind the scenes in the Church of Scientology.
I was put in a trash can, cold water poured over me, slapped.
I know it's wrong. It needs to get exposed, it needs to get confronted, and it needs to get handled. It can't go on.
It's become, in some sense, the fight of your life.
Yes.
The fight of her life, because she's going toe-to-toe with a church she says she still loves. One that was, she claims, her salvation. Cook was 14 when she found Scientology, a religion established in the 1950s by the science fiction writer L. Ron Hubbard. Debbie Cook so firmly believed in Scientology that at age 17, she went to work full-time for the church, joining their religious order called Sea Org. She rose all the way up to the rank of captain at the church's so-called flag base in Clearwater, Florida.
Welcome to the Mecca of Scientology.
But in around 2005, Cook says she started to see high-level members of the church behave in ways she found deeply disturbing. It began, she told us, when she was asked to start working more closely with the leader of the church, David Miscavige.
One quality that has always set us apart is that we are unselfish. Yes, we have an utter monopoly on workable solutions, but we share those solutions with anyone who reaches for them.
Miscavige, who has led the church since L. Ron Hubbard's death in 1986, is famously close with the world's best-known Scientologist, Tom Cruise.
The most dedicated Scientologist I know.
I have never met a more competent, a more intelligent, a more tolerant, a more compassionate being. We are lucky to have you, and thank you very much.
But Debbie Cook has testified in court that she saw Miscavige punch a fellow Scientology executive.
You punched him in the face?
Yes. I've never seen anything like this before. Never.
And you had no inkling that it was even possible?
No, I never conceived of that. I mean, I've been in Scientology since I was 14 years old. I was on staff since I was 17. At that point, it had been more than 25 years being there. I'd never seen anything like that. It was inconceivable.
While she says Miscavige never hit her, she did testify that he ordered his secretary to do so.
And she did it.
And she did it very hard, yes.
Hard enough that you fell down?
Yes.
Why did he ask her to do this?
You know, he was displeased about how I was answering a question wasn't what he wanted to hear in some way.
Did you feel like you could retaliate?
No, absolutely. You are definitely not able to retaliate.
And listen to what she says Miscavige told his assistant to do on another occasion.
He told her to grab my finger and to break it if I don't answer the question. So she grabbed my finger and bent it back. And, you know, my initial answer wasn't good enough, so she, you know, cranked it a little bit more, and she never did break it, but yes, that happened.
Did you ever think to yourself, maybe I'm in the wrong church?
No, I never had that thought that I was in the wrong church. I think that somebody else was in the wrong church, or someone else was in the wrong place, I should say. This doesn't belong in church at all.
In repeated letters to ABC News, Scientology officials have denied that David Miscavige ordered Debbie Cook to be slapped, or to have her finger bent back, or that he punched a fellow executive. In fact, the church sent us a letter signed by the executive in question in which he said this alleged incident did not occur and I would remember it if it had. But Cook is not backing down.
You stand by what you've said.
I absolutely do.
In her testimony, she goes even further, alleging that in June of 2007, while she was working at the Scientology International Base in Southern California, she was suddenly and physically removed from an office by two large men while she was on the phone with David Miscavige.
He was asking me about various projects and was unhappy that things had not gotten done to his satisfaction. And then soon after that, the window was pried open. These two guys came through the window, and Mr. Miscavige asked me on the phone, "Are they there?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Goodbye." And then I was physically taken off with these two guys to the hole.
The hole. According to Cook's testimony, it was located here in a pair of double-wide trailers on the international base.
And when I was there, it had bars on the windows and security guards posted at the one door for entering and exiting.
What do you have to do in order to be sent to the hole?
You have to really have caused what Mr. Miscavige considered to be, you know, harm, or, you know, you've really done enough bad that you're being sort of quarantined in the hole.
And when you're in there, can you leave?
No, you cannot.
What would happen if you tried to leave?
You can't. You just can't leave. There's guards at the door.
Coming up, what Debbie Cook says happened to her and the other executives inside the hole and the church's response.
So as devotees, the Church of Scientology is the only way forward to mental clarity, spiritual enlightenment, and as its members call it, clear. Debbie Cook, a former church official, says she still believes that, and yet she's taken the stand in a Texas courtroom to testify that church officials held her against her will in a place known as the hole that church officials deny even exists. ABC's Dan Harris continues his exclusive interview.
I'm Debbie Cook, captain of the Flag Service Organization.
For 17 years, Debbie Cook was one of Scientology's highest-ranking insiders. But according to her court testimony, in June of 2007, she was forcibly taken to the hole, located here on Scientology's international base in California. It was, she says, a place for Scientology executives who had fallen out of favor with the leader of the church, David Miscavige. Cook testified she was in the hole for 7 weeks, that she and the other executives were fed a sort of slop, that the place was crawling with ants, and that the temperature at times reached 106 degrees.
What did you do all day?
Most of the time, the activities were either you confessing your own sins or bad things that you've done, or getting another person to confess theirs. People are screaming at you, and in some cases, sometimes you're made to stand in a trash can. Water's poured over you.
That happened to you?
Yes.
Did you break down at all?
I did, yeah, I did.
The church denied our repeated requests for an interview. However, their lawyer sent ABC News a letter saying flat out the hole does not exist and never has. The letter did say that Cook voluntarily participated in their program of religious discipline, but that she was not taken there by force or held against her will, and that her account of what went on is inaccurate and misleading. In her court testimony, Cook says several months after she left the hole, she decided to leave her position in church management. In this videotape released by the church, Cook and her husband Wayne are seen signing contracts, agreeing to never publicly disparage the church or its leadership, and accepting checks for $50,000 apiece.
And you have high regards for the staff that you work with?
Very.
And how about the boss?
Yes.
Talking about David Miscavige. Yes.
For more than 4 years, Cook remained silent. But just a few weeks ago, when she sent out this email to a large group of fellow Scientologists, complaining, among other things, about her belief that David Miscavige had accumulated too much power, the church sued her for breach of contract. Cook's lawyers argue that the contract is unenforceable because, despite what Cook says on this videotape,
and you're doing this voluntarily, no one has made any threats or forced you to do anything?
Not at all whatsoever.
She now argues she only signed under duress, something the church denies.
You know, I would have signed that, you know, I stabbed babies over and over again and loved it. I would have done anything, basically, at that point.
In a flurry of statements to ABC News, the church describes Cook's allegations using words like false, salacious, defamatory, fiction, untrue and distasteful, sensationalistic, and revisionist.
Essentially, they're saying that you and your husband are bitter, defrocked apostates, that's their term, and that you're part of a group of heretics. I believe the church term for that is squirrels. How do you respond to that?
I have never lost my passion or love for the church and all that it stands for and all that it does to help others. So I'm not bitter. It's really out of that passion and love and care that I am doing this to rid it of a situation that has grown out of control. Nobody knew Flag like I did.
In our interview, Debbie Cook repeatedly insisted that her complaints were not directed at Scientology generally, only at the current leadership, especially Miscavige.
It's not the church. It's not Scientology, and it's not Hubbard. It is a tyrannical individual operating in the church that's doing these things.
However, the church sent us numerous letters from Scientology executives describing David Miscavige in glowing terms. The church says the real story here, as told in this upbeat ad they've been running on national TV of late, is the explosive growth of Scientology, with 25 new churches built in the last 5 years alone, along with extensive anti-drug and human rights programs. The church now says Debbie Cook can no longer enter any Scientology building and cannot even call herself a Scientologist.
It's very hard. It's very traumatic for me. And the only thing that drives me is the fact that I hope I can affect a change, and I hope I can in some way help to get it back to what it is supposed to be, what it was always intended to be.
How optimistic are you that you can do that?
I don't know. I'm not sure.
For Nightline, this is Dan Harris in Bull Verde, Texas.
Church officials say they're pressing forward with their case against Debbie Cook, and that each time she speaks publicly, it will cost her for violating her confidentiality agreement. Cook says she's aware of those risks, but they're worth it if it brings reforms. Thanks to Dan Harris for that.